It's a sort of a special kind of relationship. It's not that Nandalal believed in everything that he did, nor did we. Many of those people who admired Gandhi for various things he has done. And even if Tagore had different things to say about various issues, they respected each other and they thought they had their own kind of role in the regeneration of the Indian nation. So, and this has been kind of an influential, in a way, in at least drawing up the, let us say, a kind of a blueprint for sort of a building of a new India kind of a thing. Whether that blueprint is being followed is not, it's another matter. But it is true that their ideas, one side or the other, I think. Now, to tell about Gandhi's visit, I mean, it will be an interesting thing because I saw Gandhi in 1945 or end 44 or early 45. He came from Noakhali. And he had raised this C.F. Andrews Memorial Fund. And he wanted that an institution in C.F. Andrews' name should be started in Yeh. On one side, to sort of focused on social medicine, that the villagers around will give sort of a proper exposure to medical facilities. And on the other, sort of have a library and a center for interreligious talk. He came and it was about, how much, about 4 years after the death of Tagore. So in a sense, he was the mentor and the custodian of the Tagore legacy. So he went around and visited every institution. They showed him around. He was very outspoken in whatever he said about it, what it was or what he thought it should be and things of that kind. And there was also a fine get-together of all the people who asked questions, and he sort of answered those questions. So I remember that, yeah, and there were certain interesting things to hear. He did want to put this cornerstone to ensure that the money will be used for this purpose. And he thought that after doing the ritual, they will conform to it. And when we were all around to see what Gandhi does and what the Gandhi does not, so early in the morning when he was going to the ritual, he was up and about. He used to stay in that mud hut in the Tagore complex called Shyamali. Then he and the troop just walked out and were ready at 6 o'clock in the morning. Then he found that Tagore's son, Rathindranath Tagore, was not still there. Then people said, no, no, he is trying to bring the car for you. Then it seems Gandhi is supposed to have said that he will walk the whole distance because C.F. Andrews was somebody so dear to him. I don't want to go in a sort of a vehicle for that. So everyone had to walk with him. I mean, it's not very far, hardly a kilometer. So they went there. Then he sort of went through the ceremony, put in the A. And everything was arranged in a rather tasteful manner. That is, when they put the cornerstone, they sort of put the cement, and with the kind of mantra, they water the whole thing. So when he lifted the jug, which was supposed to hold water, the water, there was no water in the jug. So he's supposed to have smiled and said, now this, I was there, so I have seen him say that. So that I hope the fate of this institution is not just like this. And really speaking, the fate of the institution was, they had the cornerstone done. Till today, there is no institution of that kind except a small clinic, one room made for a year. And there also nobody sort of sits regularly or does anything. So this is what happened at that time. Anyway, after that, when he went around the institutions, of course, he had not very much to say about Kala Bhavan. He was very happy, and then his relation with, yeah. But then, at one time, though, in the last sitting, Nandalal is supposed to have questioned him about, because he says that, well, I have done this with this institution, it has a sort of a reputation, I have, but then, what will the future hold for me? So he's supposed to have said more or less to mean this, that you hold on to the present, the future will look after itself. So you do not have to worry about that, this kind of. So, and similarly many people said about money, we don't have money, how do we run the institution? And Gurudev is not there. He had said that if you have hold on to Gurudev's ideas, then the money will come by itself. But don't try to sell yourself to other ideas for money, this kind. Then at the last moment, at that time, there was one of those Tagore relatives called Indiradevi Chaudhurani, who was Pramatha Chaudhry writer's wife, who used to be head of the music college. Then she said that, I have a question to ask, what do you think of our program? So he was in a hurry to catch the train, so he told her that, well, I am in a hurry, but I will answer your question by letter. Then he apparently did that the next day, saying that, I am impressed by what you do, but I suppose your horizons are not large enough. You seem to think all music starts and ends with Tagore's music, and that's not quite true. And there are all kinds of music in India, both South Indian and Northern Indian, Carnatic music and the And then I would think that in an institution which claims to be a world university, you should have even Western music here. It is written, and that's EA. So he was critical in a way. He had a kind of a soft corner for the institution. He eventually tried to broach the government to take interest in the institution, making a yay. Only there, these people didn't brief them rightly, otherwise they could have had changed the whole yay of the nature of the. This, I have been witness to that at that time.